psychology major, so I'm gonna break this down into terms that you'll understand. My ego, it's super strong, okay? But it's not strong enough that I can just go around dating garbage people. Like, yes, I could find a random girl who wasn't popular, and yes, if I started dating her, she would then become popular.
Hot.
What? You are so lame.
You know that? God, I love all that death stuff. I got my first boner watching Faces of Death. Show me the body.
Seriously?
Why did you bring me here, Chanel? Show me the dead body.
What the hell, is this some kind of joke?
Oh my God, she's alive. Miss Bean's alive.
Yeah, or somebody stole the body.
There's a serial killer on the loose. Please don't say you want to choke me.
Okay. Jeez. Sorry. Uptight.
A boyfriend.
Well, I sort of am your boyfriend, and I'm protecting you by having sex with you.
I'm sorry. I think we need to take a break.
What does that mean?
It means exactly what you think it means. I need you to leave right now.
I'm sorry, are you breaking up with me, Chad Radwall? This is not what it looks like.
He has a huge boner!
Boone? Chanel, okay.
I can't believe this. You're gay?
No. Boone was scared, so I let him crawl into bed with me. Because he's my bro.
He's your gay bro who has a big boner for you. Why don't you go in there and ogle his big old bro?
Chanel, and you better not tell anybody Boone's gay, even though he is, because golf rats are big on gay dudes, and because we like hitting golf balls with gay straight alliance kids, and I would like to keep doing that. And second, look, I'm sorry everybody wants to have sex with me. Okay, I can't help that. Newsflash.
I regretted what I said, and I just wanted to come here and tell you that I'm so sorry.
Well, I accept your apology. And now I'm breaking up with you.
What?
You know why I'm breaking up with you? Because you are a spoiled, homophobic little girl who can't handle the fact that everybody on campus just wants to get with me. You can't deal with how hot I am. So you need to get out because we are over. I'm breaking up with you.
No.
Sorry, I just broke up with you. Bye. Everybody listen up. Chad has something to say.
Chad.
Chanel. Look, ever since I broke up with you, I banged like 50 chicks. Also, my best friend Boone, he is dead.
Hey, I mean, how are you feeling?
Okay, I always wear protection, and it's not like I love these chicks.
You love me?
That's not what I said.
You love me.
Stop saying that. Look, Chanel, you're hot. I guess, I mean, your boobs are symmetrical and you shave your box in a hot way. Here, go for Chad Radwall.
Chad, it's me, Chanel.
Well, 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 isn't this a coincidence? I was headed over to Kappa House to steal some of your panties.
Oh, Chad, that's amazing. I love you so much. Yeah. But Chad, listen, you have to help us.
I love you, Chad. Hello?
I love you too, sort of.
Oh, Chad, you've come for me. Save me and I'm yours forever.
I'm not really sure I'm ready for that level of commitment.
Chad, please! I'm trapped in the house with a killer! Break the glass!
Not until you take back what you said.
Fine! Just save me, Chad!
And?
And I'm yours for an amount of time you feel is appropriate.
Stand back for a
minute. the game is not truth or dare or lie. Just truth or dare. If you want to lie, you can just pick dare. I am super turned on from her, and I need some sweet release. Is there any, like, Crisco or cooking oil here? Just, like, dry handies bum me out.
I have a better idea.
Can I pick Chad? Wait.
I'm making out with you. I'm making out with you so hard.
Mm-hmm. Chad.
Mm-hmm.
Chad. Mm-hmm. I want to take our relationship to the next level.
What?
Well, I want us to be together, but I want it to mean something.
Yeah, no, I'm ready to do this.
What, really?
Definitely. I mean, I love boning girls all over this great land. But really, at the end of the day, I just kind of want to bone one girl. Like that one special girl.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, I just didn't think that girl was you because obviously there's so much wrong with you. But then I think about the good things about you. Like how gullible you are. How rich your dad is? And when I think about that girl, the really rich one who's easy to trick, I think she's pretty special too.
Chad?
Chanel.
Will you get back together with me?
Look, all of these murders on campus have caused me to do a lot of soul searching. And I think I've arrived at a place of deep personal awareness. So I would consider taking you back under one condition. You have to pinky pledge that you will be monogamous to me. You will not have sex with anyone else. Do you understand me?
Okay.
Oh, Chad!
If you get murdered in those tunnels, I promise I will never bang anyone harder than I banged you.
Chad,
let's do this.
I love you.
You're so rich and hot.
And if I gently rub Rammy's belly for 8 to 10 minutes, she will relax enough to allow milking that could yield up to 2 liters of nutritious, lactose-free protein that keeps this bod looking hot, you know?
Oh, Chad, I'm so sorry. I mean, that makes so much sense. I'm so sorry I doubted you. I promise I'll never let Dead Number 2's messages get between us again. She's clearly trying to break us up from beyond the grave.
Look, you just can't let dead people get to you. Okay, they're super pissed off they're dead, so they're coming from a place of anger.
I know.
Look, if it makes you feel any better, we can totally bang if you want.
That would be so nice.
Oh, I gotta milk Rammy first. She's super relaxed right now, and that butter's like bursting. You got a hot mouth.
Thank you.
That mouth would look even better. It was kissing all over my rippling pecs and my rock hard abs.
Okay, Chad, that's you complimenting yourself.
That outfit? Amazing.
Thank you.
That outfit, it would look even better just rolled up in a little ball in the corner of my bedroom.
Okay, Chad, that's not a compliment.
That outfit looks super absorbent enough to wipe down this hot pot after an hour-long bone sesh.
These aren't compliments, Chad!
I'm trying, okay?
I must have forgotten to tell you ladies about Chad's proposal.
What proposal?
That's right. Chad and I were enjoying a very romantic compliment night.
You're so hot, you give my bone a bone.
Thank you for that compliment, Chad.
Chanel, you know how you've been talking about taking our relationship to the next level?
Oh my God, this is happening. This is really happening.
Chanel Oberlin, will you accept the silver turkey wishbone necklace and accompany me to the Hamptons to spend Thanksgiving at the Radwell family compound? You're gonna meet my mom, my dad, my brothers Thad and Brad in the house. Awesome. It's on a 50,000 acre cranberry orchard that my great, 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 great grandfather, Prentice Radwell, bought off the Shinnecock Indians for 6 glass beads.
What?
Yeah, her name was Debbie and she and Thad were dating, but he didn't give her a silver turkey wishbone necklace, so she was not invited to Thanksgiving, but showed up anyway and then hung herself in the orchard and now the whole house is haunted.
Oh.
Yeah, like, you know, like the furniture just starts screaming or like you'll crack open a Mountain Dew and you'll start to drink it and then it'll just turn to blood. We're gonna have like the dopest time.
Is it true about Hester? She's pregnant.
I really screwed up.
So it's true.
Take her home to Thanksgiving.
Wait, what?
I'm sorry, Chanel. That's just how the Radwells roll. We make our beds and we line them. We line them with our creepy neck brace scoliosis wives. But look. You could still be my piece on the side.
No, this is not happening. I will not tolerate being treated this way. Do you understand?
I just don't get what you want me to do.
I want you to pay.
Hold on, what?
You heard me. You are gonna pay big time for this, Chad Radwell. You might even just pay the ultimate price.
Ultimate? Wait, hold on, did you just threaten to kill me? Chanel, are you the killer?
I guess we'll see. You don't have to marry that psycho cow Hester because you don't have a baby on the way, if you know what I mean.
No, I don't know what you mean.
I have killed for love, Chad. I've killed for our love.
What?
Chad, Hester was never pregnant. She just said that so you'd invite her to Thanksgiving with your family in the Hamptons. But then She had a little accident down the stairs.
Oh, what? Wait, are you saying you killed Hester?
Gravity killed Hester. I just gave her a little push.
Oh, that is so hot. I want to see it. I need to see the body. Look, we can have a three-way with the body.
What? No!
Oh, come on. I need this.
No friggin' way. Where is she? Oh, also, the Oberlins came over on the Mayflower.
Oh, well, women. So many wonderful women to go out with and break up with and move on from.
But you should be thankful that this table is too long for me to reach across and strangle you, bitch!
Well, I don't want to sound like a dick here, but have you ever considered maybe you should leave? I mean, with you and Hester here, this Thanksgiving, it's spiraling out of control. And later tonight, we're about to get together and play Pictionary. And as it stands now, if I gave him a Pictionary, it's going to be super awkward.
You can't be serious. Chad?
You haven't eaten yet, have you?
I knew it. You've come back. You've chosen me over your awful family.
Hold up. First of all, my family's awesome. How dare you? And second, yeah, I did come back, but it's only because I knew you'd have turkey here, so I thought I'd get my turkey on with you. I'm sorry I said that. What's up, guys?
Insane asylum in the middle of the night and scared me in my bed, and it's not funny now.
I thought it was pretty funny. Maybe not Happy Gilmore funny, definitely Big Daddy funny.
What is that screaming?
It's my good buddy, Randall. He needs medical attention. I think he's gonna die. Front man. It's called gold-plated nutsack. Chanel, you have no choice but to reject this man and that gay murdering hand and start boning me again.
Chad!
Chanel?
Chad! What is going on?
What do you mean? Why does something have to be going on? Can I just ask you to, you know, meet me in the park and walk and talk some things over?
No, Chad, you can't because it's super weird and it seems like you want to murder me. I mean, I actually brought a stun gun. When was the last time you wanted to A, go for a walk with me, or B, have an actual conversation?
Let's walk and talk. Look, I've been doing some soul searching. I don't know why. Maybe because another one of my friends is missing and presumably murdered. Or because there's a hot surgeon with a murdering hand obviously trying to get in that box. Anyway, I've been thinking about you and me and us.
Okay.
Chanel, I'm in love with you.
What?
I told all those other chicks I was banging how awesome it was that they didn't have wangs, and I was in love with them.
Really?
I was in love with you.
Really?
Love, it's a funny thing, isn't it? Chanel Oberlin, will you?
Oh my God.
Pedro?
Oh my God, is this really happening?
Get your lawyers to look over this prenup.
Are you asking me to marry him?
Oh, not really. No, I'll consider asking you to marry me once you sign the prenup.
You're going to want a whole legal team to kind of look over this. There's a lot of stipulations and some pretty specific riders.
Chad, I feel like I'm in a fairy tale. Yes, yes, 1,000 times, yes!
We were all there.
Hey, Chanel Oberlin, bereaved fiance of dead.